And Radio Network. Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
It is Wednesday, the 21st day of December, 2011. Our nation and the rest of the world, from China to England, from Russia to Mexico, is being imploded by design and brought to its knees through controlled depression. We have this from the IMF and World Bank documents, BBC 2002, their plan, and they are now carrying it out. Massive new banker bailouts, which is really just direct taxation over the population to the big six megabanks. Much of it, U.S. taxpayer money, has now been announced in Europe. Last year at Davos, they wanted $100 trillion in new taxpayer money. The power to tax is the power to destroy. The globalists want to shut down all of their competition. The worst of the worst have competed to get control of society. They engage in high-tech propaganda to manipulate and befuddle and bamboozle the dumbstruck population. We are here to shake people out of their morass, out of their dazed existence, to become actual actors in the game of life, to be on the field, not mindless, programmable spectators, nothing but virtual biological androids. I knew this would come. I knew that Louisiana and surrounding areas were a beta test. I knew at the time they were going door-to-door confiscating guns in the high and dry areas and killing U.S. citizens. It was all a big exercise in martial law and media control. The government cut the police lines. Sheriffs and others went public. They jammed police communications as the storm hit so they could claim that the police stood down and set a pretext for FBI leading regular army, big army, National Guard, and military police and SWAT teams from around the country. You saw that happen almost 6 years ago. Now, as the welfare state implodes, as the crime accelerates in Chicago, in fact, I'm going to have Paul Watson and Nemo add this right now, in Chicago and in New Orleans, but the new article is on Louisiana and New Orleans. Remember Blagojevich just a month or so before he got indicted? You can pull this up. It was in the Associated Press and the audio of it. And said, we want National Guard and regular army doing door-to-door gun sweeps. And they've actually had them now in Chicago quietly. So we should, by the way, add that caveat to this to show folks that it is a Democratic Party, but Bush did it as well, operation where they've got state reps on TV saying we want troops on the streets to stop the guns and the drugs. The guns the government ships in and the drugs the government ships in. Here are the articles by Paul Joseph Watson and Alex Jones. Louisiana state officials calls for troops on the streets. National Guard engage in door-to-door gun confiscation during Hurricane Katrina. That was a beta test. And here is Kurt Nemo's excellent article, top story at Infowars.com as well. Martial law attempt in Louisiana echoes Ron Paul's warning. Do I need to tell you to get these articles and get them out on Facebook, Twitter, YouTube's got social network systems as well? Do I need to tell you to do that? This is an absolute red alert because in Iowa, in Indiana, in California, in Florida, in Michigan, in Illinois, in Boston, in Dallas, Texas, different cities, statewide, you name it, they're having knock and talk where they come now with the army, with the police. This is in the news. We'd like to talk about your firearms today, ma'am. Mind if we come in? And then they basically force their way in. In Boston, they admit they just forced their way in. No warrants. And they are really getting the police drilled and ready to commit these crimes under peer pressure. And so it's on. I've got the audio and the video from CNN. Coming up on the other side of this break where they're like, absolutely. Let's put troops on the streets and let's get those guns. That's how you fight crime. The war on drugs is not going to be the war on your guns. and the same people ship both in to the criminals.
Hundreds of nations have fallen to tyranny in the last century alone. This is our last chance to not relive history.
As we're finishing off this agenda, they'll be pulling the rug from underneath Americans at home.
They have tremendous influence on our president and Congress, and they really are calling the shots.
I think it's incumbent upon all of us as American citizens to pay attention.
Fall of the Republic identifies the enemies of our nation, the criminal offshore cartel, hell-bent on destroying sovereignty and on its ashes constructing world government.
Tim Geithner, Bernanke, they're arsonists. They're asking for more matches. And the Congress is saying, who do we make the check out to?
Today seems like nobody does care. And right now in Washington, D.C., we have seen a fall of the Republic.
Get your copy of Fall of the Republic on DVD at Infowars.com or watch it online right now in super high quality at PrisonPlanet.tv.
Hi, this is Alex Jones. This holiday season, more than half of our nation is in need of help due to the shattered economy. So now is the time to express the holiday spirit more than ever. Consider helping those you love with the most important gift. A supply of delicious, easy-to-fix, and very storable foods from eFoodsDirect.com. Their holiday gift and family packs start at $99 for a 16-day supply, while their 5-week supply of quick and easy-to-fix meals includes a personal backpack in case of a grab-and-go emergency. Order their combo gift pack, and you'll save hundreds, plus get free shipping on your entire order. Call eFoods today at 800-409-5633 or visit them online at eFoodsDirect.com/Alex to find the special. That's 800-409-5633 or eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. You can bet your life on eFoods Direct. A very wealthy U.S. citizen is predicting that in 2011, we will witness the most important day in America in more than 50 years. He says it will change everything about our lives. The way you shop, travel, invest, educate your children, and even how you take care of your health and your own family. Now, this man has made some outrageous predictions over the years. The crazy part is, he's usually right. You see, he predicted the collapse of GM, Fannie Mae, Freddie Mac, and America's biggest mall owner, General Growth Properties. In fact, Barron's called his work a dire prophecy. Recently, he created a video, which you can watch online for free, detailing his biggest and most important prediction yet, and it's a real eye-opener. I can't stress this enough. You should at least watch this free video online today. He explains everything you need to know, including simple steps you can take to protect yourself. You can find the video at www.endofamerica3.com. That's endofamerica3.com. Watch the free video at www.endofamerica3.com. That's endofamerica3.com.
He's the T-Rex of political talk. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
Strap yourselves in today, my friends. This is incredibly important information. Unfortunately, day by day, week by week, month by month, year by year, our worst concerns are proven right, and our analysis is just absolutely devastatingly on. Because we're following globalist documents, planning, drills, we reversed engineered the parts that aren't declassified and have just been absolutely spot on. If I have to say we've been 99% correct on the big picture, it's because the 1% is that it's just always worse than we thought. It's always worse than we thought. The criminality that we have in the government and in the mega corporations that control it is unparalleled in history. Now, you know that there are literally hundreds of newspapers and TV stations right now, including CBS News, Bloomberg, Associated Press. I can't even track it all. And I got up at 5 a.m. this morning, only spent about 30 minutes on that, and there were hundreds of them saying Ron Paul is nuts. He believes there's a plan to put military on the streets. He is insane. This is, and of course, Alex Jones is just as evil. I'm in the articles as well. And they have links to where he said it on my show. This is when we have endless congressional clips and more we found on C-SPAN that are up at Infowars.com right now with the entire Congress basically going, yes, Obama can now kill any U.S. citizens he wants, torture them, arrest anybody. Well, let me tell you something. Just because you claim you have dictatorial powers, just because some teleprompter reader and the criminals that put him in office and bankrolled him say that, doesn't mean it's so. And, of course, these powers will be passed on to the next person. I don't even think they plan on making Obama a dictator. It's the office of the presidency that the bureaucracy and the special interest puppeteer. That's who is going to use this power. And they might use it next month. They might use it 2 years from now. I'm not saying they couldn't pull something like that, stage a bunch of domestic terror attacks, start arresting opposition, shut down the internet. I mean, they've said they're going to do all of this. You know, it's not kooky anymore. When you talk about internet censorship, it's all over the internet. The head of the FCC is warning about it right now. Google's come out and said it's true. And the Pentagon says, we don't care. We'll shut down what we want. I mean, it's even creeping out some of the powerful elites that are out there because this is getting down to the wire. And I want to say something. I have seen, again, literally scanning over them, 50 or more articles that I had time to look at. From Red State and CBS, you name it, attacking Ron Paul. And almost every comment is for Ron Paul. It is not just some highly vocal minority that swarms every article. It is people on Red State that say, hey, I'm not even a Ron Paul supporter, but stop lying about him. And so since they pulled out the stops 2 days ago and started the racist smear, like they did on Rand and all the rest of it, his numbers have gone up even more in Iowa and New Hampshire. So it's definitely backfiring right now, which shows you, and I've watched this process for 17 years on air, 19 years awake, tracking media intensely every day. I've never seen the awakening this turbocharged. And I can tell you, I can feel the establishment. I can see it in their actions, their memos that are public because they're so arrogant still about how great a new Oklahoma City would be to blame on domestic groups, Financial Times of London, Democratic Party press releases. I mean, they don't even veil them. Even Glenn Beck said a year ago, they're getting ready to stage new Oklahoma cities, pointing at Democrats on the screen and blame it on conservatives. You bet they are. I mean, they don't even hide it. They think we're so dumb. They think you're so dumb. Even though they're a little awake and a little concerned about the awakening, they still can't help their old arrogant instincts. And so last night we re-showed those memos and documents and clips of Glenn Beck admitting that the government's preparing to stage terror attacks. Look, if you don't come to grips with the fact that criminals have hijacked the federal government and call their bluff and realize that they're staging the terror attacks and they're financing the Muslim terrorist in every major case and protecting them and that they're setting up domestic groups. If you don't come to grips with the facts, they're going to use this tool to gut this country. And that means devalue your dollar and take your pension funds. Just as sure as the sun rose this morning and just as sure as it's going to set this evening, it is going to happen. They are following a recipe, a blueprint, a program, a plan, a operational manual that they've done in countless countries. The Army's false flag manual was leaked by WikiLeaks 4 years ago. The Army did not deny that that was theirs. They said, we're going to find out who released this and we're going to prosecute them. Okay? I've had a lot of family in the Army, folks, who were officers. And let me tell you, what they will say will blow you away. And they're saying it's a lot worse than that. Okay? Stop being naive little kids, okay? America's the big global empire. Not the American people. They're in a narcoleptic state, you know, walking through life literally in a dream state. America, look, America has murdered 51 million of its babies and just says, oh, they're not humans. So don't tell me evil can't happen. It is happening. We had a government 60 years ago shooting black men up with syphilis and watching them die over 45 years. We have a government that sterilized 500,000 women in this country on record because they had below a B-plus average. under eugenics. We have a government that 5 years ago was admitted in the New York Daily News until the story got shut down because CPS workers wouldn't be that evil. And they said, we grab little black kids and we take them who are totally healthy and we give them to Big Pharma. Here are the facilities. And a month later, they're dead. They're dead. In some of the studies, they give them pesticides and strap them down and kill them in the course of a month. I mean, ladies and gentlemen, you sign on to this government, you might as well get on your knees and say, Satan, I love you, and I want to go to hell. And I know you worldly people don't believe in the devil.